Oh, would you look at this? Look what that other guy left me this time. Oh, that guy does not like me. 7 lines. All right, let's see if we can figure out what's going on here. My man John attended a festival with 3 exhibits. Now, here's how he worked the festival. He walks into the first exhibit, pays his $3 admissions fee, then blows half the money he has left on souvenirs. Drops another $3 on some food, out the door he goes into the second exhibit. Then he does the same thing. $3 to walk in the door, then he blows half the money he has left on souvenirs, $3 more on food, out the door, into the third exhibit. And John's not very original, he does the same thing again. $3 to walk in the door, spends half his money on souvenirs, and then $3 more at the end. And that's it for him because he is tapped out, he has no more money. Now here's the question, how many dollars did he spend while he was at the festival? Well, you know we want to turn all these words into math because we don't want to look at all those words. So we're going to start off, we'll assign a variable. Let's do that. We'll say that he starts with X dollars. And now we want to keep track of what happens to his bankroll here as he's going through the whole festival. Now, I don't want to look at all these words, don't even want to think about them, so I'm going to build a table. It's going to help me follow everything a lot better. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to have one row for each of the exhibits. There's the first exhibit, there's the second exhibit, and then there's the third exhibit. So he's going to walk into the first exhibit. Now we're going to keep track of what's going on at each step as he's going through the process here. We want to see what he has left after admissions. So he's going to walk in to the first exhibit here, he's going to pay his $3. He started with X, so after admissions, he has X minus 3. And then he's going to go blow some money on souvenirs. So let's see what happens here. It's after souvenirs. He's going to spend half the money he has left. He has X minus $3. He goes, spends half of it on souvenirs, so he has the other half left still. So the amount he has left is 1/2 of X minus 3. All right, then he's got the munchies. He's going to go get some food. This is probably where I'd be spending all my money. He's going to go and he's going to spend $3 on food. This is how much he had before. He's going to spend those $3. Here's what he has left. 1/2 of X minus 3. And then we're going to subtract another 3. I don't want to keep doing this. I'm going to have to put all these algebra expressions all over the place. Oh, there's got to be a better way to do this. I have to put one here, then here, then here, and then we'll go all the way to the end. And hey, wait a second. We already know what the one at the end is. The one at the end is 0 because my man's all tapped out. He has no money. He has 0 at the end. Hey, if he has 0 at the end, that means he only had $3 when he walked in to buy the food in the third exhibit. We can go back here and say after he got done with the souvenirs, he must have only had $3 left because when he spent those $3 on the food, he was done. So after the souvenirs in the third exhibit, he must have only had $3. I'll bet we can keep walking this back. Check this out. If he only had $3 after his souvenirs here. Now when he went and bought the souvenirs, he spent half the money he had left. Which means after he spent that half, he had the other half. The other half was 3, so the amount he must have had before he bought any souvenirs in the third exhibit, $6. He must have had $6. Then he spent half of it on the souvenirs, and bam, he has 3 left. We can keep working backwards. We could have thought of this right from the beginning, and here's how. We had some good, solid information about what's going on at the end of this process. We didn't know where it started. That's what we're trying to figure out, but we know where it ends. So we're going to start from where we end and we're going to keep working backwards. If he had $6 after the admissions to the third exhibit, he must have had $9 before that admissions because he spent $3 on admissions. So he must have had $9 after the food in the second exhibit when he got finished with the second exhibit. Now, of course, he bought that food for $3 in the second exhibit, so we can walk one more step backwards. He must have had $12 before the food, and he spent his $3 on the food, and bam, he ended up with 9. So he had $12 here in exhibit 2 after finishing blowing half his money on the souvenirs. He spent half the money on his souvenirs. He had $12 left. That means he must have spent $12 on the souvenirs, so he must have had $24. Right before going and buying all those souvenirs, he spent half that 24, ended up with just 12. So he's got 24 after the admissions. One more step backwards, he had 24 after admissions, he spent $3 on those admissions, so we know he had 27 on those admissions. Now we could just set these two equal, solve the equation, but we're so close, let's just keep walking it back. He had $27 after spending the $3 on the food in Exhibit 1. That means he had $30 before buying the food. He had $30 after spending half his money on souvenirs. That means he had $60 before spending half the money on souvenirs. Had $60 after spending $3 on the admissions. Yeah, we know that he started with $63. I like doing things backwards. All right, let's try one more problem. One more problem right here. Now here we go. We're gonna play a little game here, all right? We're gonna start off. I'm gonna give you a third of my brain cells. Reach in my brain, pull out a third of my brain cells, I'm gonna give them to you. You're gonna take my brain cells and put them in your brain, and hopefully you'll get smarter. Put them in your brain, mix them all in there real good, all right? So you're gonna have a new, bigger brain. And then you're gonna take two-thirds of your new, bigger brain, two-thirds of those brain cells out, and you're gonna give them to me. And I'm gonna get a whole lot smarter with all your brain cells. I'm gonna put them in my head, mix them in there with the brain cells that I still had left after giving you some. And then after I mix it all up, I'm gonna take a third of those out back to you. And then you're gonna take those third and you put them in your head. And when we get done all this, you and me, we're gonna have the same number of brain cells. We're gonna be equally smart. How about that? All right, now here's the question. What's the ratio of the number of brain cells that I have to the number of brain cells you have before we even start this process? All right, so here we go. A lot of words, you know what? We'll start. Hey, wait a second. This is just like that last problem, right? We know something about the end. We know that you and I, we're gonna have the same number of brain cells at the end. And we're trying to figure out what happened back at the beginning. So let's try working backwards again. Let's try that. So we'll say, at the end, I have X brain cells. And you have X brain cells. That's what happens at the end. So now let's take a step back and think about what happens before I give the last one third. All right, before I give up that third, what was going on there? Now, when I gave you that third, at the end I ended up with just X brain cells left. So, you know, if this is X over two brain cells, this is X over two brain cells, so that's what I have at the end. There's that other X over two brain cells there that I gave to you. So I started off with 3x over 2 brain cells. Now another way we could have thought about that is that x in the end, that's the two-thirds that I had left after giving you a third. So in order to figure out what I have before, I have to multiply that by 3/2. So it's 3x over 2, I'm going to give up a third of that to you. I'm going to give up x over 2, I'll be left with x. And you'll be left with x as well after I've given you x over 2. So that means you must have had x over 2 before I gave you this last third. And that makes sense. We can check that right here. If we add these two up, we get 2x. We add these two up, we get 2x. And that's good because we're not bringing in any extra brain cells because, hey, between you and me, you know, between the two of us, we don't need any more brain cells. We're doing pretty good. And, you know, we're not giving up any brain cells either. We're not dropping some on the floor. We got to be careful. All right, so now we know what's happening right before I gave you the last third. Let's see. We'll go one more step back. Before you give two-thirds, we gotta go one more step back. So here's where we were after you gave up two-thirds of those brain cells back to me. So if this is what you had after you gave up two-thirds, this must be one-third of what you had before you gave up two-thirds. So you must have originally had three times this. So if this is one-third of what you had, so you must have had 3x over 2 and then gave a full x to me. Well, that means I must have had x over 2. You gave me a full x, and boom, up to 3x over 2 we go. And once again, we see we add these up, we get 2x total. So no brain cells gained overall, no brain cells lost. That's good. One more step to go. One more step back. we're going to figure out what's going on at the start. Now what happened here is I've got x over 2 left after giving you a third of my brain cells. Now we can kind of think the same way we did when we did this step right here. I could multiply this by 3/2, or I could think of this x over 2 as being, well, here's x over 4, here's x over 4. Those two together make me an x over 2, and here's that other third x over 4 that I gave to you. So there's x over 4, x over 4, those are the ones I keep, and then there's this other x over 4 that I gave to you. So I had 3x over 4 to begin with, and you must have had 5x over 4, because once again, these two have to add up to 2x, because we're not losing any brain cells here. So I had 3x over 4, I gave you x over 4, that dropped me down to x over 2, and you went up to 3x over 2, and wait a second. This means the ratio of my brain cells to yours is 3 to 5. That means you have more brain cells than I do. You're smarter than I am. That's because you just finished all the pre-algebra videos. You're done. It means you don't need me anymore. What am I going to do? What are you going to do? Wait, I know what you're going to do. You're going to do this. Oh, that's awesome. I have a whole lot more videos to make, but I'm going to read up a little bit so I can get ahead of you.